Bookish friends, welcome to November wrap-up part 1. In this video, I will first of all talk about the 8 works that I finished in the first half of November. And then give a brief update about my progression on my 3-month reading challenge, Berna's Bookish Bingo. The first work that I finished in the month of November was a graphic memoir, and I read this memoir for nonfiction November. Adulthood is a Myth by Sarah Anderson. In this graphic memoir, there are snippets of Sarah's life as she tries to adjust to being an adult during the period in which she finishes the university and gets a job. And also she has a boyfriend during that time period, and she makes comical observations about her life and draws them in comic panels. Even though I liked some parts of this graphic memoir very, very much, and I really identified with some of them and really laughed a lot, I have to say it was not as funny as I expected to be. I read some of the panels and the stories it was telling, and I just kept a straight face. I didn't find it funny at all, but the drawing style and the representation of the feelings were really good. So I gave this graphic memoir a 7 out of 10. I plan to continue in the graphic memoirs collection of Sarah Anderson. Second book that I finished was a book that I started reading in the last days of October. It was called Zıkkımın Kökü by Muzaffer İzgü. This is also a non-fiction book written by a very famous Turkish author. And he tells the anecdotes from his childhood while he was living in Adana in a very poor family. But during this time, he and his family never gave up and tried very odd works when he was little and also a teenager. And the anecdotes are written in a wit way, actually. And I liked the wit of this book very much. On the other hand, I thought it was sort of romanticizing the poor conditions of the childhood. And this romanticizing bothered me a bit in some sections especially. So in summary, this was also a 7 out of 10 book for me. Then I read the book that I was going to read for New World November. It was called The Beast by Jenny Foster. I read this for the prompt of an alien, because one of the creators of this New World November Readathon, Becky, is very fond of blue alien romances. And while we were chatting in the comments, I made a promise to at least try one of this blue alien romance books. The Beast by Jenny Foster was a prequel to a series. In this book, blue aliens do come to the planet Earth to kidnap women who are reproductive to ensure their species' survival. And the commander of this blue alien ship falls in love with one of the captured women. In the second half of the book, there is also a murder mystery, and the duo then tries to solve this murder mystery. What did I think of this book? I'm actually glad I at least tried this subgenre, but I really didn't like the concept of having alpha males as the heroes of these stories, and some of the terminology which is I think very commonly used in these subgenre really bothered me, like prey, my Amazon, my woman, and surrender. So it was clear actually from the start this subgenre is not something that I would enjoy very much. But additionally, for this book, the murder mystery, which was introduced in the second half, made the plot very complex, and also some new things were introduced which came out of nowhere, which really bothered me as a lover of mystery genre. So that's why I gave this book a 5 out of 10. I then finished another non-fiction book, which was Erzurum Yolculuğu by Alexander Pushkin. This was the memoir of Alexander Pushkin when he visited a city in Turkey, Erzurum. And the English title of the book is Journey to Erzurum. It was a very short memoir. It focused on what he saw on his travel to Erzurum. I will give my detailed thoughts about this book in my Turkish video, which will feature this book at the end of this month, I think. In summary, I can say that I was really impressed by how much this book packed in so few pages. Also really loved the descriptions of the buildings, the environments, and everything else he saw during his journey. It was beautiful. The Turkish representation was a bit dubious for me, because this journey was made during the war with Ottoman Empire. I think it was natural that he felt hostility towards Turkish people during that time. I gave this memoir an 8 out of 10. I then finished my Agatha Christie book of the month, which was By the Pricking of My Thumbs. This was the next book in Tommy and Tuppence series. Our amateur detective husband and wife duo investigated the suspicious disappearance of a woman in an elderly home in which Tommy's aunt used to reside in. Always enjoyed the light-hearted mood of Tommy and Tuppence series, but this book had a much more darker mood. There were some hints of supernatural occurrences, and the way that Agatha Christie introduced the mystery was incredibly good. Very, very creepy, actually, because I also really do like the darker moods books of Agatha Christie. I actually gave this book a higher rating than the other books in Tommy and Tuppence series. And it is also not a very long book, and I think it will be a great book to read for the Christie's Missing Readathon, which will occur between the dates of December 3rd through December 14th, which is a readathon that is co-hosted by Naomi at Naomi's Bookshop, Kevvie at Ses Kevvie, and myself. I will link our announcement videos and all of the information down below. This book could be used for reading an Agatha Christie book, or a book that does not feature the detectives Poirot or Marple. I think it's an excellent mystery, and I gave this book an 8 out of 10. And the next book that I finished was also for New World's November. The theme of week 2 was robots. And I read a middle grade book which was written in 1970s. My Robot Buddy by Alfred Slote. In this middle grade book, a boy really does want a friend to play with, because they live in a bit of secluded area. He asks his parents to buy him a robot friend. Together they form a wonderful relationship and go through a small adventure. Because this book was written in 1970s and the technology was a bit outdated, the important thing, I think, was not the technology in this book. The important thing was the beautiful friendship between the robot and the human child. And also there was a very wonderful theme of loving somebody even if they are different. It was not a very long book like most middle grade books are. And it was perfect for this readathon. I gave this middle grade book a 7 out of 10. After My Robot Buddy, Last Piece of My Heart by Paige Toon. I actually chose this book in a reading blog in which I tried first chapters of the books that were recommended by Emily at Novelle Novels. And this book was my favorite. In this book, our heroine is asked to ghostwrite the sequel book of a very successful book written by a recently deceased author. Our heroine also doing blogs about how she visits her ex-boyfriends, asks a piece of her heart from them because her original idea was that she left her one piece of her heart with them. For writing this sequel, she goes to the hometown of the author, in which part of the book takes place, and spends time with the late author's husband and her one-year-old daughter. I listened to this book with a smile on my face all the time. There were some scenes which were very, very cute, and there were some issues which were a bit sad, were touched upon, but the hope was always in the book. I especially loved the relationship between our heroine and 1 year old, wonderfully cute little daughter. And I really did love the writing style of Paige Toon and how she formed her characters. I want to thank Emily for recommending this author to me. I will certainly read more books from Paige Toon, although it could have been a little less detailed and more shorter in the middle section. I think it was a great feel-good book and a very, very fine example of literature that is termed chick lit. I gave this book an 8 out of 10. But the last work that I finished in the first half of November was an autobiography, actually, by Katharine Hepburn, one of the stars of the old Hollywood. The title of the autobiography was Me, Stories of My Life. And she told her stories from her life, beginning from her childhood until 1991, in which this book was written. I was especially impressed by the family that Hepburn was raised in. Her mother was one of the suffragettes, and she believed in the strength of women. And that told me so much about Katharine Hepburn that I heard also watched from her movie. Even when she played merely a romantic lead, all of the characters she portrayed had inner strength, at least. And sometimes she played very forward-thinking woman, and I can see why she was so natural, because she also was a very forward-thinking woman. I really did like her initial advice in the book, which was not to give up even when you fail in the path that you're following. She was also very honest, and she criticized herself actually a bit ruthlessly at times. The most touching section in this autobiography was the section about Spencer Tracy, how she loved him. When I finished listening to this autobiography, I thought she purposely omitted some parts of the stories that she was telling. But then I figured out I listened to an abridged version of the book, and suddenly it made sense that some parts felt a little bit unexplained. So the rating that I give, 7 out of 10, is actually the rating of the abridged version, which I listened. As for Berna's Bookish Bingo, in the first half of November, I managed to fill out 6 prompts. I read Adulthood is a Myth for the prompt of a red cover book. I read Zıkkımın Kökü for a non-Turkish non-fiction book. I read Erzurum Yolculuğu for a short book, less than 200 pages. I read By the Pricking of My Thumbs for a book belonging to an adult series. This book is a part of Tommy and Tuppence mystery series. I read My Robot Body for a book read in the website Internet Archive. And lastly, I read The Last Piece of My Heart for the prompt of a book about books. So those were the 8 works that I finished in the first half of November. Please comment down below what was your favorite book that you read in the first half of November, and have you read any of the books that I mentioned in this video, and what do you think about them? If you're a new viewer, first of all, welcome. Please like and subscribe. Hope to see you very soon. Bye. As for Turkish Word of the Day, since one of the books that I really liked in the wrap-up video was The Pricking of My Thumbs, I thought thumb should be the word of the day. Thumb means baş parmak in Turkish, and baş parmak are our Turkish words of the day. Have a good day!